Rockets, missiles, and launch towers standing as sentinels against the Florida skyline at Cape Kennedy Air Force Station, Florida, comprise a unique museum developed by the U.S. Air Force. The display of space vehicles and associated equipment is located on the exact launch site of America's first successful satellite, as well as other milestone flights. The nerve center for launch activities was the blockhouse. Within these protective concrete walls, the equipment which was used to conduct the countdown and launch of those historic flights is displayed by the Air Force to preserve moments in space history. Inside this very blockhouse on January 31st, 1958, a small dedicated launch team headed by Dr. Kurt H. Debus prepared for an historic event. The flight of America's first space satellite, Explorer 1. A Jupiter C launch vehicle, visible to the launch crew through the blockhouse windows, was set to carry the 32-pound payload into orbit with only a fraction of the thrust of today's more powerful rocket. In the blockhouse, the launch team waited patiently for high-altitude winds to subside. Then, the prestige of the United States rose with the Jupiter C rocket, which lofted the tiny Explorer 1 satellite skyward. Ninety-eight minutes later, orbit was confirmed, and chapter one of American space history was written. A pathway to space exploration was opened, and the first small step to the moon was accomplished. Later, on May 28, 1959, Abel, a rhesus monkey, and Baker, a squirrel monkey, were donned in special biomedical apparel. Their historic flight would answer many questions about the hazards of space for manned flight. Scientists were particularly interested in the effects of weightlessness and radiation on living organisms. The Army Jupiter rocket carried the monkeys to an altitude of 300 miles and flew 1,500 nautical miles downrange. Finally, man himself was ready to venture into space. On May 5th, 1961, Commander Alan B. Shepard arrived at the launch pad where a Mercury Redstone rocket stood ready, fully fueled, and checked for America's first manned flight, a brief suborbital ride to an altitude of 115 miles.
Freedom 7, the fuel is go, 1.2 G, cabin at 14 PSI, oxygen is go.
Other historic space flights have blazed skyward from these launching pads, many of them rare and forgotten missiles. but all of them have contributed to the accomplishments of America's goals in space. And here at Cape Kennedy, the Air Force Space Museum has permanently preserved moments in space history.